Thank you. back to my YouTube channel. So as you can see, I have my handsome boyfriend Zach with me, and today we will be making our taco recipe. We've been making this recipe at least 4 times a month, I feel.
At least.
Yeah, we've been like actually loving this, and I felt like you guys wanted to see what we do and how we do it, so you guys can do it for yourselves and like your friends and everything. So we already started cutting our ingredients. So the first one we did was the shrimp, and we literally cut it in 3. And we also have our tomatoes and diced tomatoes, and then we also have red onions because we didn't like the flavor of the white one. So yeah, I highly recommend onions. You doing the red one. And we also have some cilantro. Zach loves the smell of cilantro. It smells so good. And we also have in this tiny little bowl, we have some green onions. And here we're trying something new today. This is some
sweet peppers.
So it's bell peppers. Because it smells so good, I feel like it'll add some flavor. Yeah, I think it'll add some more flavor to the shrimp, which is really good. We're also gonna make some guacamole to add to our shrimp taco. And here we have the avocados and the limes. And we also have some jalapenos because Jeffrey, my best friend, gave me this recipe, and we're gonna try it.
It's so much better with the jalapenos.
Yeah. Okay, guys, so enough talking. We're gonna get started.
Okay,
guys, so to start, we're gonna season the shrimp because you always want to have more flavor in the shrimp before you actually cook it. So we're gonna start with the Old Bay seasoning. We're gonna
This is the main thing that gives it its flavor. It's amazing. This is like the golden. I don't know what it is or what it's made
of. I know. I feel like it's a mixture of a lot of seasoning in there, but it is for seafood, so I did realize that. And we also need some onion powder, which is really good too.
So how much of each?
Usually we eyeball it, which is, my boyfriend doesn't really like when I do that, but that's the best way.
But in general, more bay seasoning than,
yeah, than the onion powder.
For sure.
Perfect. And we're just gonna mix it together. So now we're gonna start with the ingredients. First, the onions. Tomatoes. And we're gonna add some cilantro. It's kind of like making a salsa, but except we're frying it. And then next, we're gonna do the green onions. And then lastly, we're gonna do some
sweet peppers.
It's gonna really make it smell amazing. Basically what we're doing is making them like kind of like fry them, but not too much.
Like sauteed
them a little bit. Yeah.
And then we'll add the shrimp.
Yeah. Okay, so now that we sauteed the ingredients, we're just gonna add the shrimp. So literally, you're just gonna pour the shrimp.
So when it looks like that, that's when you add the...
Yeah. Yes. It's looking good. and you just gotta mix them. You're gonna let the shrimp cook for about, I would say, 5 to 10 minutes, right?
Yeah, 10 minutes.
Yeah, 10 minutes. And you just gotta keep checking it. I'll show you guys what they look like when they fully cook. But yeah, it's looking so good. Okay guys, so I'm gonna do the guacamole right now. So what I'm gonna do is just remove the avocado from its shell. So this is what it looks like. So what I'm gonna do next is put the jalapenos. And we're gonna put some onions. We're also gonna put a little bit of cilantro. And we're gonna put some lime. This is our guacamole. Do you want to try it?
How much of this do we have?
So good. Very spicy. This is so good. Okay, so while the shrimp is cooking, we're gonna start our shells. So we're gonna pour some canola oil in a flat pan. Any flat pans that you have will work. I usually use a lot because you want the shells, the tortillas to actually like sink in instead of actually staying on top. Yeah, so we're gonna wait till the oil is really, really hot to drop the tortillas in there while you're like checking on your shrimp. Okay, so to make those beautiful shells, all you gotta do is put the tortilla in the very hot pan and you gotta fry it a little bit. Keep turning it because the pan is like really, really hot.
Doesn't take long.
Yeah, it doesn't take long at all. So just keep turning it. As you can see, it's already like turning brown. And then you just curve it a little bit just to get the shape. Just like that. And you just fry it like that on this side. And then you just turn it the other way and fry it on that side too. I'm not really a big fan of like too crunchy, so I don't let it stay in the oil for too long, but it's your preference. And this is a perfect shot. Okay guys, so now we all set. All this needs to do is eat it. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh my god, so good. Amazing.
Oh my god.